It's time for another DNA matchup, this time between 23andMe and MyHeritage with their competing chromosome browsers. Howdy, I'm Andy Lee with Family History Fanatics, where we help you understand your DNA, climb your family tree, and write the story of your ancestors along the way. We're talking about chromosome browsers today, and we're going to compare the chromosome browser in 23andMe and the one in MyHeritage. Now, I've been using the 23andMe chromosome browser since 2013 when I had my first DNA test, so I'll admit I've got a little bit of a bias towards them, but we're going to see who's going to come out on top. Now, I want to know who you think is the best chromosome browser between 23andMe and MyHeritage. Put it in the comments below. Do you like 23andMe's browser better, or do you like MyHeritage's browser better? Now, the first category that I want to compare is the number of people that you can compare together in a chromosome browser. Instead of just doing a one-to-one comparison, I want to do a one-to-three or one-to-five or something even more. So which company comes out on top? If we go over to 23andMe, we can see that we can have up to six people. We're comparing one person to five other people. So that's six people that are being compared at the same time. Now, how does MyHeritage stack up? Well, if you see here, and if you count all those little lines in each one of those chromosomes, you're actually comparing eight people. That's eight. That is two more than what you can compare in 23andMe. And so guess what? I'm giving the win to MyHeritage because you can compare more people. Now, one thing I will say is that with the 23andMe chromosome browser, you can compare anybody that you share DNA with to anybody else that you have shared that information with. With MyHeritage, you have to compare one of the kits that you manage to any of the other kits. So after the first round of fighting, it is MyHeritage 1 and 23andMe 0. But let's go to the second round. And in the second round, we're going to be looking at half identical regions and full identical regions, particularly whether or not the company calls out which parts are half and which parts are full. At 23andMe, when you're looking down the chromosome browser, each line represents a comparison between a different person, and they're represented by a specific color. But you'll notice, particularly when you're comparing siblings or first cousins, double first cousins, basically any relationship that will have fully identical regions, you're going to have two different tones in those lines. There'll be a darker tone, which is going to be the fully identical region, and there will be a lighter tone, which is the half identical region. So 23andMe reports information on both the half identical region and on the fully identical region and makes it really easy for you to see which one is which. With MyHeritage, they just report the half identical. They don't show you which parts of that chromosome are fully identical. So on this match here, I had me and my brother as one of those matches, and it doesn't identify any regions that we both share in common fully. Only the ones we share halfly. That's a new word I'm making up. 23andMe gets the win, and we have a tied game now. Both 23andMe and MyHeritage each have 1 point. Let's see what they can do in round three. In round three, we're going to look at whether or not you can download that segment data. Now, there are some programs like DNA Painter that you can upload this segment data to get some more useful information out of it. So you got to be able to download that information first. At 23andMe, down below the graphic of each one of the chromosomes, there's going to be this table that shows each one of those segments, both the fully identical and the half identical. And you can just highlight all of that and copy it, paste it into a spreadsheet, or paste it into DNA Painter, or paste it anywhere else that will take this type of segment information. It's really easy, and it's all there available for you. If we go over to MyHeritage, when we scroll down to the bottom, we can actually see that, yeah, you can actually download that segment information. Just clicking on that button is going to download all that segment information for whichever matches you have selected. And you can open that up in an Excel file, copy that over into DNA Painter or any other program that will take this segment information. So it's a tie. Both of these companies have a great way of getting that segment information to you, so that you can use it elsewhere that you may want to. This means that after getting a point for each one, that it's still a tied game, 2-2-2. And that's going to bring us to our fourth category. And this has got to be the tiebreaker, so somebody has to win. Now, the fourth category that I chose was X chromosome information. The reason why I chose it as the fourth category is because not every DNA problem is going to need X chromosome information. But it is a little bit more data, and there are some cases where knowing that X chromosome match or no match could be helpful in identifying what that relationship is. If we go to 23andMe, we see that, hey, they've got the X chromosome right there for you, right at the bottom after all of the others. And they tell you the half match and the full match on that. So you can get all the X information you need from 23andMe. But what about MyHeritage? Unfortunately, they got data on all 22 of your autosomes, but they don't have any information on the X chromosome. I'd have to go and look back at the raw data file that you can download from them. I believe there is some X information in the raw data file, but as far as what they're displaying to you on their website, they don't show any, and that means no segment information on that. You're not going to see it in the chromosome browser. So 23andMe wins this round, and that means overall, 23andMe has 3 points and MyHeritage has 2 points. So 23andMe gets the win. Don't take that as MyHeritage shouldn't be used, because I use both of these websites, both MyHeritage and 23andMe. They each have different tools. They each have their advantages. They each have their disadvantages. I would encourage you, if you have not tried out either 23andMe or MyHeritage, to log into those websites and try out their tools. In upcoming videos, I'll go and compare Family Tree DNA and GEDmatch with their browsers to some of the others. But for right now, just tell me, 23andMe or MyHeritage. If you have any questions, put it in the comments below and I can answer it. If you'd like to see our last matchup about triangulation, go to this video up here. If you're just beginning and you want to have a bunch of videos to learn how to do genetic genealogy, then check out this playlist at the bottom. Be sure to subscribe to our channel and click on that bell if you want to be notified about upcoming episodes.